guys my advocacy, what is it all about, and also the actions that I made in order to become an advocate during this time of pandemic. So let's start. My personal advocacy is preserving and maintaining the beauty of our environment. Our natural resources are rapidly depleting because of different human activities that affect our environment. People are engaged with excessive quarrying, deforestation, burning fossil fuels, and a lot more that are considered as reasons of the destruction of our environment. Recently, a lot of Filipinos suffered from Typhoon Kinta, Rolly, and Ulysses, which caused severe floods, landslides, and damage to the human life and their livelihood. So, we all know that the Sierra Madre is the longest mountain range in the Philippines. It runs from the province of Cagayan to the province of Quezon, forming a north-to-south direction on the eastern portion of Luzon. There are lots of trees in mountain ranges which help in preventing floods and landslides during calamities. But why do we suffer from this even if we have the Sierra Madre? Why can't it protect us during certain calamities? It is because excessive deforestation and quarrying happens at the location of the Sierra Madre. It can no longer protect us from landslides and severe floods because there are no more trees left, since people keep on utilizing natural resources that are beyond our limits. Aside from this, marine life also suffers from human activities like overfishing, throwing off residential and agricultural waste to oceans, and a lot more that results to water pollution. Because of this, the marine life is threatened. If we keep on doing these activities, we might have a much polluted environment that may cause harmful impacts to our health. This is why I chose this advocacy. We need to preserve our natural resources because it has limits. It has boundaries. We cannot always have these natural resources available at hand. Also, we should maintain the beauty and diversity of our environment, because we are considered as stewards of our environment. We must act now before it's too late. In my advocacy, my ultimate goal is educating and opening the eyes of Filipinos in the reality of our world. I want them to know what is really happening in our environment. Also, I want to encourage them to do actions that will help us in preserving and maintaining the beauty of our environment. In this current time of pandemic, wherein we cannot go outside freely and human interactions are limited, I can take actions by participating in social media or internet-related activities of the non-governmental organizations or NGOs that promote my advocacy. The NGOs that promote my advocacy are the Greenpeace Philippines and the Marine Wildlife Watch of the Philippines. First, we have the Greenpeace Philippines. It is a non-governmental organization that uses a non-violent creative action to pave the way towards a greener and more peaceful world and to confront the systems that threaten our environment. Second is the Marine Wildlife Watch of the Philippines. It is involved in various projects and activities that aim for a better appreciation of the marine environment, its ecological processes, and how it affects us all in the local context. You can visit their site or you can contact them. I will post the details below. I participated through signing various petitions, sharing it on my social media accounts, and signing up for campaign updates and action alerts. So, let's talk about the petitions that I've signed. First, we have the Break Free from Plastic campaign of the Greenpeace Philippines. So, what is this all about? Over 90% of plastics have not been recycled. Countries in Southeast Asia, including our country, Philippines, are used as dumping ground through global waste trade. By signing this petition, we will be able to challenge certain companies like Unilever, Nestle, and Coca-Cola to stop using single-use plastics. I also participated in the making of the plastic monster, which symbolizes the plastics that companies are using, which destroys our environment. I also encouraged my friend to take part on this movement. We posted it on our Instagram story, where other Instagram users saw it and became aware about this issue. Next, I also signed the Ban Foreign Waste petition of the Greenpeace Philippines. So, why is signing this petition important? It is because a 9-container van of waste from Australia and a 40-foot container van from Hong Kong were discovered in the Misamis Oriental. Other countries are making us dumping ground for waste importations because the Philippine government does not ban the entry of foreign waste to our shores. By signing this petition, we will urge the President to declare a ban on the entry of foreign waste and will ask the Senate to ratify the Basel Ban Amendment, which will put an end to the practice of developed countries treating Philippines as their dumping ground of waste. Another petition that I've signed is the Protect Our Oceans campaign of the Greenpeace Philippines. By signing this petition, it will help us in asking the government to do actions that will help us in protecting our marine life. Lastly, I signed the Bataris petition or the Sharkada of the Marine Wildlife Watch of the Philippines. So, the word Sharkada, or short for shark barkada, is a term used to call individuals and groups that support the shark conservation in the Philippines. By signing this petition, we will be able to urge the Philippine Congress and Senate to pass the shark conservation bill that aims to ensure the shark populations in our country are conserved. Aside from signing these petitions, I also shared it on my Twitter account and encouraged my followers and mutuals to sign the petition as well. By simply sharing these petitions, I was able to spread awareness about these issues as well as encouraging others to take part on these actions because we are all in this together. We need to help each other for the betterment of our environment. So, that's all guys. Thank you very much for listening. I hope that this video enlightened you guys to take part on this too. You can also help in preserving and maintaining the beauty of our environment by signing petitions, sharing it on your social media accounts, encouraging your friends to help, and a lot more. You may think that this may be just small and simple steps, but I guarantee you, it has a big impact in protecting our environment. We can simply spread the word and we will be able to contribute in the changes in our world. So if you have the ability to help, go help. If you want to be an advocate, be an